Hi friends, in this video I am explaining how to do the part 5 of mission wise. So this is the front view and top view. Okay, part 5 is screw rod. Okay, so here front view is vertical dimension, vertical it shows, but I am doing the in horizontal manner. Okay, so what is the dimension? First circle is 32 diameter and 40 length. I will take the side view, take the circle and draw the circle 32, close sketch, and give the length of 40. So take the symmetric and give the length 40. Okay, so after that you have to go for the non-symmetric, diameter 20 and length, total length is 170 plus 40. Okay, so take the side view, so you can take the sketch also, you can take extrude, take the circle. So diameter is 20, close sketch, and give the length 170 plus 40, 210. So give the non-symmetric, give the distance 210, finish. Okay. So next extrusion, look at the diagram. So what is the diameter is given? So diameter is 12 and length is 18. Okay. So take the extrude and select this tip. In this phase we have to do the extrude. So take the circle command. Okay, draw the diameter 12, close sketch, and give the extrude 18. Okay, finish. Next, last extrusion in the continuation of phase. So that is the M10 is given in the diagram. Okay, and what is the length here? 22. Okay, so take the diameter. M10 is means you have to take the diameter 10. Okay, so draw the circle 10 and give the length, that is 22. So this completes the extrude part. Next you have to go for the threading. What is the threader? Where is given the thread and where is you have to make a round. So in the first part it is given round of radius 3, exactly in the first circle, tick mark. Okay, so round is finished. Next you have to go for thread. Okay, in last part you can look at this one, that is the M10. M10 is given means that is the thread part. So it is fully up to extrude 22. Straight thread you have to use at a distance of, you have to select the cylinder and select the tip. Finite element already 22 is there. So go for the change the type of the thread. So which thread is given here? M10. Carefully look at the diagram. M10 is given. So we have to select the type of thread M10. Finish. Okay. So at the tip of this one, you have to make the chamfer. Okay. So chamfer dimension is not given. Just you have to give the 1. Tick mark. Okay. So next thread. Where is given the next thread is the second cylinder. Select the cylinder and select the tip of the cylinder. Okay, select the thread, straight thread. Okay, so select the cylinder, that one, select the tip of cylinder, then and it will open. Finite value, that is 170, only 170 is given. Here the thread is 20 into 2. Look at this one, the diagram, 20 into 2. Finish. Okay, and here you have to give the chamfer up to 2. So type it 2. Select this one, tip, tick mark, finish. Okay, so what is remaining now? Look at the sketch. Okay, so threading is over, chamfer is over, round is over, remaining is through hole at the first part. Okay, so using the top view and the front view, we have to make the cut portion. Okay, so cut portion is given. So select the top view first, choose the cut command, select the top view, and what is the circle diameter is given in the question, that is 10. Diameter 10 is given. Select exactly at the center 10, close sketch, and make the symmetric cut, that means both sides, any distance out of the diagram you can give. Okay, next select the front view, front plane, same diameter 10, close sketch, and you have to select out of the diagram any distance, finish. So this completes this part. Okay, now save this part as a part 5 in any folder. Keep it all the parts in one folder. Okay, now saving is completed. Next you have to give the material property and title of the part. So material property, check the table. What is the material property is given for part 5? That is Fe410W. Okay, so type it, apply to model. Right, next you have to give the title using file property, go to summary, and you have to give the part name, that is screw rod. Okay, so this completes the diagram. Okay, thank you.